I've been a grad intern this summer, and I'm going to be a senior at the University of San Diego studying marketing and finance this year. So instead of talking about just one project, I want to do an overview of my entire summer and what I've learned and what brand really means. As a lot of people are like, oh, you're a brand intern, what does that mean? So I'm here to take the time out to explain what that is. So before I go into it, I want to discuss really what I thought I knew what brand was before the internship, what I learned during the internship, what brand actually is, and then how it's implemented through the customer experience as well as through growth. So first, before the summer, I thought I knew what brand was. Obviously, if I wanted to be the brand intern, I had to know what brand had to be. Well, what I thought it was the emotions that is tied to a company name like Nike. What emotions does that spark? Is it, what feelings does it give you? And this is something that I thought I knew, but didn't really know the full impact that this had on a company and the full impact it had on the customer experience. During my 12 weeks as an iAspire intern, I learned a lot during my time here and want to go through the full impact of what brand means. So what does brand mean? Brand is really in the essence or the promise that a company delivers. And when you think about essence or a promise, it could be something like BMW, which is their promise is the ultimate driving machine. They want to give you the best experience that they can. It's also the persona that a company portrays, the human characteristics that we portray as customers onto the company and that the company tries to cultivate to progress onto it. At Illumina, this brand persona that we have is progressive, driven, illuminating, and perceptive. Here, what we try and do is we try and cultivate that in everything that we do, whether that's from our messaging to our products, all across the board. A big thing about brand is consistency. Really, what brand underlines is the customer experience. Going back to brand being a promise that we deliver, we have to make sure that we deliver on our promise to our customers. If we do that with our branding and through what we produce, our customers are going to have a great experience and they're going to come back more and more times. So how does brand impact the customer experience? Originally, what I thought brand was just how people hear about the company. So how is that messaging throughout everything that we do? We want to make sure that Illumina is consistent, whether you hear about us through an RGH space, an oncology space, or just through an article that you hear. We want to make sure that the brand persona that we give across and the promise that we think we deliver is being expressed consistently throughout the entire time. What I didn't know was how much further that really progresses into it. One aspect that I worked on this summer was product packaging. So when you think about customer experience, as soon as you go through the sales process and you decide this is the product I want to have, now when you order it, it shows up at your doorstep. So what does this experience look like? With brand, what we want to do is create an emotion as soon as you see that package on the doorstep. So how does that orange package, what thoughts, feelings, emotions does it spark? Is it consistent with our brand persona that we try and portray the entire time? During my summer, I had the opportunity to analyze some of our competitors' packaging to try and harness our efforts towards making our product packaging better, and that's a new initiative that we'll be rolling out shortly. A further step that I didn't fully realize that branding had that dives a lot deeper into something that we kind of take for granted is product naming. This is something that is actually used a lot more than you think with the product name. When someone goes through the entire sales process and they go to purchase a product, they don't say, oh, I just want that Illumina thing. They use the actual product name, such as the Trucy RNA Amplicon sequencer, or Amplicon panel. So this name is used a lot, and it's important to make sure that we're consistent throughout the entire company with what we're doing. Because, like I said before, if you hear about us in an RGH space versus an oncology space, let's say you happen to be a customer that crosses over, we want to make sure that our naming is consistent. With consistent naming, it also helps our customers navigate our product portfolio, because if you know that you need something for a library for our product, or you need something that's specifically for RNA, you have to be able to navigate our product portfolio to find what you need efficiently and effectively. Over my summer, this is what I spent a lot of my time on, was creating a product, interactive repository of our product names to help our naming process get more efficient. I took the thing with consistency is across the company, there was some inconsistencies with different software of how we had our products named, with our spelling, with different types of spacing, and really there was inconsistencies. So I took 3,500 lines of our product names and whittled it down to the 245 products that we have, consumable products that we have, and was able to generate new naming recommendations to create consistencies going forward. The other thing that brand really has a huge impact impact on is our growth. So as we grow, brand is kind of a framework that keeps everything consistent and makes sure that as we grow, we're staying within the boundaries of who we want to be as a brand and nothing is out of control. The first aspect of that comes into is onboarding. So how is the onboarding process when we have a new hire that comes into Illumina? We want to make sure that they get the same information whether they're in San Diego or they're in San Francisco or they're in Madison or they're in Singapore. We want to make sure that that's consistent throughout the process. Not only that, but not only do we want external customers to believe in the brand persona that we have at Illumina, but we also want our internal customers, our employees, to full-heartedly believe in our brand persona, because if we believe it internally, that's externally what we're going to display with our customers. I was able to work this summer within global marketing to help optimize our onboarding process and create a curriculum to help get this process more efficient and get everyone the information they need in the optimal method. I was also able to put together an acronym list used within global marketing to be able to talk with a bunch of people in different departments to make this the best possible. The other aspect that brand goes through that I didn't think about too much was facilities. So how do our buildings look? As we grow and we create new buildings, like Building 6 that's going up and I-3, and we have new campuses going up, how do we make sure that our culture that's here and the beautiful campus that we have, how does it expand? How do we make sure it's consistent? This goes down to the images that we use on the wall, the colors on the wall, the carpet, the wording that we use on posters throughout the building, as well as even the chairs that we sit in. Lastly, with brand that facilitates growth is how do we pick up new talent? How do we recruit? And this is an aspect that I spent a lot of time with. And really what it comes down to is with our brand persona, not only is it customers that are using it, but also future employees. So when future employees find us, we want to make sure that they're coming to us because they believe in our brand persona, our promise, our essence, what we want to do. One thing that we are working with at Illumina is trying to express this culture that we have here externally. One aspect that I saw as an opportunity to do this through was through Snapchat, as many of us use Snapchat a lot in our generation. And so it's a way to off the cuff, give an inside look at what's going on at Illumina as an authentic way to see what's going on. And also, if you go to the company picnic, there will be a Snapchat filter for the company picnic, so check it out if you're on Snapchat. It's also a way that we can express ourselves and our brand through the interactions that each of us have day to day outside the company. So really, brand is only the beginning of the story. Brand is all about creating a positive sentiment and emotion that our customers have, both internally and externally. Brand is really the final piece of the puzzle that ties everything together and wraps a nice bow around everything. It makes everything consistent and keeps that brand persona and that image that we want to have consistent throughout. Lastly, I want to thank my team for everything that they've done and everyone that I've worked with this year who's been here. I could not have done it without you. I would not have grown professionally or personally or intellectually without the help of you guys this summer. So thank you very much. And this is the final overview of my projects. I worked on the major ones. The only one I didn't touch on was branding of cities. So one thing I looked at was how we can brand San Diego as the capital of genomics, as that's something that we're trying to harness with there being so much genomics talent in San Diego. So looked at how other cities, the Silicon Valley, how they were able to brand themselves and how we can use that going forward. And so that's an